Welcome to the High Vibes Reset Day number 2. I am so glad you're here. Today's lesson is all about clearing your vibes. In day 1, we spoke about how important it is for us to remove that distance and space between us and our higher power. And we do so by inviting the inner teacher to stand at the forefront of our heart and mind. And it's from that state and from that space, we're able to work with this higher energy, this source of power, in order for us to be more connected. Now, throughout your day, and even throughout your life, you are exposed to many different energies out there. And you'll probably even describe some draining aspects of energy as bad vibes. Vibes that don't make you feel so good. Vibes that can feel overwhelming. Vibes that can be draining and hard to be around. Now, the truth of the matter is that we don't always remember or recognize that we are the keeper of our minds and of our body, and therefore we are also the keeper of our vibes. And we find ourselves being exposed to energies that are less than good, energies that can be draining and overwhelming, and energy that you don't want to give your time. With that being said, we're brought up to be, you know, well-mannered and good people. And so sometimes we find ourselves in spaces where we are suffering and our well-being is not our main focus. And so we do get drained. We do find ourselves connecting with people that aren't always good for us. And we do find ourselves having to pick up the pieces after we've been exposed to negative energies. So with that being said, we sometimes navigate our life and move through our life with these old vibes and these stagnant vibes connected to our energy field or our aura. And we don't always realize or recognize that because we haven't said release this or let this go, it's actually coming with us on our journey. Now, your vibes are your life. And what I mean by that is your vibes create your life. And so therefore, if there's any energy or vibes on your energy that is stagnant and old and gnarly, then there's a good chance that that's contributing and creating experiences for you that are less than good. And so it's important for you to learn how to clear your vibes so that you're navigating from a space of radiance and prosperity and abundance and health and well-being. And it's so important to remove this old energy so that the good energy in you is leading the way. And so today's practice is all about clearing these vibes. It's about taking matters into your own hands and your own heart and recognizing that in the moments of your life that you are exposed to energy that does feel harsh and overwhelming, you have the tools within your toolkit that you can tap into quite quickly to remove these energies from your energy so that you can tap into radiance once more. And so recognizing that you have a choice is a really exciting thing, because you're probably navigating your life and going through the world feeling like an empath, feeling like someone who's overwhelmed by energy and not recognizing that that's actually a choice. And we don't always get told we have a choice, because when it comes to information circulating the world out there, when it comes to movies and all these different things, we feel that spiritual energy happens to us rather than spiritual energy is happening through us. And so we can choose if we're going to take something on or not. And if something's already on us, we can choose to remove it from us. We do things in our life naturally to clear our vibes, and sometimes we don't even recognize it. For example, maybe you've had a really overwhelming day at the office or at work or at home, or who knows what. And you come in the front door and you're like, I'm going straight for a shower. I just need to wash off the day. There's an example of you clearing your vibes. There's an example of you, you know, just taking a minute to let go of the day. Or if you've had an argument with someone you love and you're trying to get your point across and you're not being heard, you decide to take yourself outside and you go for a walk to clear your head. There's another example of you clearing your vibes. Or maybe you're feeling really amped up or really stressed or overwhelmed and you take yourself to the gym or a dance class or to yoga, and there you're able to kind of work through what's going on in your heart and what's going on in your mind. These are all examples of clearing your vibes. And it's important to recognize that for the most part, we tend to let these vibes build up and build up and build up before we clear them, rather than making it a daily practice to ensure that we are not carrying these energies with us. When you make the conscious choice to bring in a daily practice that clears your energy, I can guarantee you, you will experience more freedom, more joy, and project more radiance into your life. Let's clear our vibes together. And the way we're going to be doing that is through tuning in, uniting with that higher power, and then a number of movements that we're going to do with our breath to clear our energy field so that we can create more space and more openness for us to experience a high vibrational state. Let's clear our vibes together. Welcome to day two of the High Vibes Reset. So glad you're here. So great to see you. Today is all about clearing your energy. So building on from what we learned yesterday, we're going to be tuning in, then we're going to be working with movement to clear our energy field so that we can create space to project more radiance. There's this quote that I love to go back to time and time again in my life, and it's this quote from A Course in Miracles that says, it's not our task to seek for love. It's simply our task to seek and remove all the barriers that stand against it. This idea that within you is this eternal presence, this eternal love, it's always there residing, waiting to shine. But it's all the external stuff, like the stresses and the busyness and the concerns of our life, that stand between us and this presence of love. Our duty is not to find love or create love. Our duty is just simply to remove everything that's standing in love's way so love can do what it does best. And so that's what we're going to be doing with this practice today. We're going to invite our inner teacher to stand at the forefront of our heart and mind. And then with that presence, we're going to set this intention to clear away from our energy field anything that's standing between us and shining and sharing this love that exists within. So finding yourself in an easy, comfortable seated position, either on the floor or in a chair, whatever works best for you. I want you just to allow your palms to face upwards. And if it feels comfortable enough for you to close the eyes down, do so now. If closing the eyes is not suitable for you for whatever reason, just bring the gaze down and dial into the breath and just take a moment in reflection, being aware if there's anything in your body that's causing tension, and just taking a moment to reach there with your breath on the inhale, holding for the count of three and then exhaling. So doing that together, deep inhale towards anywhere that you're holding tension in your body, holding for 3, 2, 1, exhale. Doing that again, deep inhale. Holding the breath, 3, 2, 1, deep exhale. Inhale. Holding the breath, 3, 2, 1, exhale. And just returning to your natural rhythm of breath.
And again, bringing your awareness to something that you are grateful for. Something that lights you up from the inside out. Whether that be a blessing, a person, a memory, your health. Tune into it now. Feel the gratitude. And when we tune into gratitude, we create this magnetic energy around us that draws towards us other reasons to be grateful. And from the state of gratitude, bring your palms together at heart center. Begin to rub the palms together, creating heat and warmth. And as we rub the palms together, we activate both hemispheres of the brain, uniting the critical and the creative as one. Setting this intention to enter a state of neutrality so that we're not attached, but open to all. And once you've done so, and you've created heat and warmth, bring the palms together at heart center in prayer formation, thumbs in towards the chest, elbows lifting slightly out. And inviting this presence of light that resides within you up and out. Inside you is this presence of light, the inner teacher. And it's the one part of you that has never lost connection to the source of creation. It's united forever, one. And when we invite that inner teacher up and out, we remove the space that stands between us and the presence of love. We remove the space between us and the source of creation. So invite that inner teacher up and out. Say, divine inner teacher, thank you for standing at the forefront of my heart and mind and for leading the way in my life and my day. And imagine this great light switching on at your heart center, shining outwards. And this light is the light that will guide you in moments of uncertainty, moments of darkness, and moments of fear. And the light that you see and the light that you are shining is your light. Today you are invited to bask within that light. And that light is a light of love. Take a deep inhale. Deep exhale. And a slight bow to that presence within. And when you're ready, hands come down onto the lap. And open the eyes. Now that you're tuned in, we're going to start doing these gentle movements with breath and awareness to clear your energy field. So inhale. Lifting the hands up overhead on the inhale and exhale, allowing the hands to sweep down the side of the body. So inhale, reaching the hands high. Exhale, bringing the hands back down. Inhale. Exhale. And if it supports you, you might want to close your eyes as you sweep the hands through your aura. Exhale, letting go, releasing. Inhale. Exhale. Sun. And as you're doing this aura sweep, setting this intention that you are clearing away anything from your energy field that's standing between you and sharing and expressing and even experiencing this presence of love. And if this is difficult for you for whatever reason, you might want to just lift the hands up. And exhale down. Inhale up. Exhale down. Inhale up. Exhale down. Inhale up. Exhale down. You'll find these aura sweeps in pretty much every style of yoga. Spreading your wings. And the idea is that the arms are an extension of the heart. And we're just allowing heart energy to polish through the aura, cleaning away any debris, any frustration, any blockages. On the next inhale, the hands are going to come up overhead. And your inhale, hands wide. Exhale, cross the hands above head. Inhale, hands wide. Exhale, crossing overhead. Inhale. Exhale. Now, if this is difficult for whatever reason, it might just have to be here or here. Whatever feels good for you. Inhale. Exhale. You've got this. Exhale. Last one. Inhale. Bring the hands down onto the lap. Just closing the eyes over, just observing how you feel. And finally, we're going to do this scooping action through the aura and overhead. It's a beautiful movement. And this idea that when you're doing so, it's like you're scooping your hands through this golden pool of light in front of you and washing it over your aura. Continuing to scoop the hands overhead and again, just closing the eyes just to feel the full experience. In some way, if you can, finding rhythm with the music. Breathing as you do so. Again, remembering you're scooping up light and washing it through your aura. Sun, 30 more seconds here. When you're ready, after your final scoop, bring the palms back onto the lap. Close the eyes down. Take a deep inhale. Let it all go. And just observe how you feel. It's not your task to seek for love. It's simply your task to seek and remove all the barriers that stand against it. Love is who you are. Love is your truth. It's here within you now. Deep inhale. Deep exhale. When you're ready, rub the palms together. Bring them back into prayer formation. And we're going to close the practice today with three Sat Nams. Sat Nam means truth is my essence. So Sat means truth, Nam means essence. And that's in Gurmukhi and Sanskrit, both two very incredibly spiritually connected languages. So we're going to take a deep inhale. We're going to go Sat Nam three times. Inhale to begin. Sat Nam. Sat is truth, Nam is essence. Truth is your essence. When you're ready, open your eyes. Thank you so much. Thank you for sharing your practice with me today. We tuned in, we cleared our vibes, and we affirmed that truth is your essence. If you want to take a deeper dive, you want to do more, if you're craving more connection, below this video, you will find corresponding lessons and a meditation to support you on your journey through this high vibes reset. I will see you tomorrow, where we work on replenishing your energy.